Okay, in this video, I'm gonna show how to work with title blocks, how to create your own and edit existing one, and yeah, basically how to customize a title block for your company. So we're gonna use an exercise that we did in one of our previous videos. And well, title blocks basically allow you to update project information such as name, client, company, your own logo, who the drafter, the engineer, etc., etc. And this first step, I'm gonna show you how to nominate the project information that is going to appear in the labels when you eventually do your title block. So if you just go to file, just go to manage, and then here just look for project information. Right, so we're just gonna use any information. So here, for example, I'm gonna put my university, so the university, Swinburne University, and then faculty, organization description, just Faculty of Civil Engineering, building name, just put, I don't know, just a number, right, author, just a Mr. A, B, issue date, just put, could be the date today, so 06, zero 3/18, project status, just leave it like that, client name, just say builder 1, address, just leave it like that, project name, just call it my project, number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then say that the engineer is Mr. C, or Mrs. C, D. Okay. Right, now we're just going to file. So we're gonna create our own. We're gonna customize our title block. So just go to a new title block. Right now we are in the English template, Imperial template. We're gonna move to our Australian template. So just English. Title blocks, and say we're gonna do an A3 title block. Okay, so we got our white sheet. I'm gonna start populating it. So for that we're gonna use lines and our drafting tool. So we use all the drawing tools and the features in modifying, so to array, copy, etc., and basically to define the borders and shapes to divide all the areas that we need in the title block. So I got a template here that I want to replicate. You cannot see it, but it's going to look something like this. So first, just a big rectangle to define the actual margins of my title block. I'm not gonna be here too accurate with dimensions, but you can change them like just similar to what you do in Revit. So for example, if you wanna make this 200 exactly the same, you just 200 and then right. Just gonna do that. And gonna start creating something here. So just lines. Okay, I wanna here a rectangle, big rectangle here, that's where the logo is gonna be. And then another small rectangle where the project number comes. All right, and here is the one, two rectangles. Here another white and one more here, right, modify, we're just gonna create some lines. I'm just gonna keep doing this process, just gonna stop, and when I finish I come back. Okay, now I've got an approximate shape of what I'm looking for, like some borders here for my title block. So let's continue. So we go to modify here, we're gonna add, create text. So text, the text can only be edited when we are in this family editor. Once you load this title block into your project, the text will remain static. So to modify it, you have to return to the family editor. So we're just gonna put some text to these fields that we have here. So right now my text is 8 mil. We wanna to do that text smaller, so just go here, duplicate, and we're gonna do a text of 3 mil. 3 mil, okay, and then just change that to 2. All right. So we're gonna put, for example, here, client. Right, and you can just drag this wherever you like that, and then I'm gonna populate all this. I'm gonna come back in a minute. Okay. Now we're gonna create labels. So if we go to labels, they display parameters. When the title block is loaded into the project. So in previous steps, we populate the information of the project. So basically, that's the parameters that are gonna change with each project. So that's the labels that we're gonna place right now. Unlike the text, the label change as the parameters change. So for example, here, I go into this first field and click, and then I get a list of the parameters that I can put in this field. So for example, here I'm gonna put the organization name. So just move here, apply, and okay. So that's the organization name. That size is a little bit big for me, but just leave that one like that. I'm just gonna create a new label here, and then this is gonna be the organization description. All right, this one a little bit a little bit too big for what I need. So again, I'm gonna change the size of the text. So let's change edit type, duplicate, and say this one is gonna be a 6.5 font. Okay, and then 6.5. Okay, or better for us. All right, I'm gonna keep populating these fields and I come back in a minute. Okay, so this is how my title block looks like with the, all the labels. Now we're gonna import a logo, the logo of our company. So for that, let's go to insert image and then we find the logo, open, and that's what we have. Just gonna scale it down to fit in here. Right, just a little bit bigger. And that's what we have for our title block. We're just gonna save this as a family, so save as family. And then I already saved it as a Swimboard title block. Just do the same and okay. I don't save because it's already in my computer, but okay. Now we just hit this load into project and grab it automatically. We only have one project open, so it's not gonna ask which project, but if you have more than one, it's Revit ask which sort of project. So this one is called working with title blocks practice. If you have one called, I don't know, new building, so it's gonna give you the option of loading that title block on one project and not the other, or both of them. Okay, so now if you go to project browser in sheets, you just right click new sheet and it's gonna give you the options. In this case, my title block is called Family One. So okay, and that's where it is. So if you want to say modify this client, see how you can't not modify this text, it just takes it as a block. So to modify them, you have to edit family here. So it also populated the information that we first input at the start of the exercise. So in manage, we put some project information. So that's the labels and it's all populated, okay. So for example here, my project is outside of my title block. So if I just go to edit family, I say, okay, this project name is probably too small. We're gonna make this field bigger. Let's see what happened. Overwrite existing version, and now my project is fitting. All right, and from here you can just bring your elevations just normally, and your views just normally like you do before in the previous exercises. Now, for example, say you want to change this type of title block, you're gonna put a different one. If you go to properties, here it says, if you select the title block, it says Family One. Just go to a different one, say A3 Landscape. So you just change it as easy as it is. And then if you wanna modify this one, you just go to Edit Family. Now, another scenario is when your company works with AutoCAD and you're working with Revit and all the title blocks are already designed in AutoCAD. How to bring that prototype or title block into Revit? So let's see that exercise now. So just like before, we are in our file here. We go to File, New, Title Block. And again, look for not the Imperial, but the standard Australian, A3. Okay, we got our blank sheet. So in here, you're going to insert import CAD. And then I got a file here that I brought from AutoCAD. Just make sure you are working before anything, just go check the units. So a shortcut is UM. Yep, units are in mils, so that's good. So if we go to import CAD, title block, import units millimeters, let's put in origin to origin, orient to view. Okay. And we just give it some time for ready to bring. Oh, wow. Let's see what happened. Okay, I come back. I think my software had some sort of problem. I come back in a second. Okay, I am back. I just have some sort of crash issue with Revit. Okay, so if we go to import CAD, title block from CAD, millimeters, origin to origin, open. So that's our title block. It's actually locked for move. Like it doesn't let me move it, so I just unlock it, spin. It seems like I selected a too big sheet, A3, but okay. Doesn't matter. Basically, what we do now here is if we explode the title block, so we can, because we cannot actually modify here anything. So, say if you want to modify this text or lines or move it somewhere, it's very difficult because it's a block. So, if I explode, oh, we see some lines are missing. So, probably not the best thing to do. Just go back. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the pick lines command for Revit to copy all the existing lines. So when we explode, we don't have information missing. So just select all the existing lines. Okay, that's good. Enter. And then modify. It's gonna select the whole title block, explode, and we got all our lines in place now. So we can modify text, we can start just the process, same process of inserting text labels, etc., etc. And same thing, just load the title block into the project. Okay, I hope this videos help, and thank you for watching.